Growing up during the time of World War II, the kids in the neighborhood watched as the older boys went off to war. I remember when Everett Hoffman left, he promised to write me once a week, which he did, and even sent me a parachute once, which I took right down the block to Gerard Frank's house, and I climbed up on the top of his garage with the parachute, and I jumped off. I thought I killed myself, but I mean, you know, you didn't admit things like that. I mean, to be a real boy, it was considered a battle scar. When Everett came home, there was something very different about him. When I saw the best years of our lives, I realized that he might have seen the kinds of things that nobody should see, and that coming home might not be all that easy for him. Such is the case for Victor Comstock, who's always having trouble making the transition back to civilian life. He doesn't even know what year it is. Betty must be wondering whether it's simply battle fatigue or something worse than that, like brainwashing that might have taken place. By the looks of things, the latter is certainly possible. Let's see how it all turns out in some time, some station.